Hi everyone, today we are going to see set language exercise 1.6, problem number 5 and 6, video number 21. Here the problem number 5 is, in a party of 45 people, each one likes tea or coffee. Okay, everyone likes either tea or coffee. 35 people like tea, 20 people like coffee. We got to find number of people who liked both and who do not like tea and who do not like coffee. Okay, first let's say that the people who like tea are called as, we can name them as tea. Okay, people who like tea, we name it as tea. People who liked coffee are mentioned as C. Okay, people who likes coffee are denoted as C. Clear? Now, we know that 35 people like tea, isn't it? We know 35 people like tea, so n of t is equal to 35. Clear? N of t is equal to 35. 20 people like coffee, so n of c is equal to 20. Here, 45 people, each one likes tea or coffee or both. So it is t union c. Okay? Either they like either tea or coffee or both. So, it is T union C, which is 45. Now, we have to find number of people who liked both tea and coffee. So, N of T intersection C. We must find N of T intersection C. We know that N of T intersection C is equal to N of T plus N of C minus N of T union C. So, what is N of T? 35 plus N of C, 20 minus N of T union C, 45. So, 55 minus 45 is equal to 10. Clear? Now, we know that the number of people who liked both tea and coffee are 10. Okay? Now, we need to find how many people do not like tea. Number of people who like tea is N of T. So, number of people who do not like tea is N of T dash. So, we need to find N of T dash. What is N of T dash? It is N of U minus N of T. What is N of U? Here we consider N of T union C as N of U. Okay? So, we take N of U as N of T union C, which is 45. So, 45 minus, what is N of T? 35. So, 45 minus 35, it is 10. Therefore, number of people who do not like tea is 10. Clear? Now, we should find what is the number of people who do not like coffee. Okay, we found number of people who do not like tea is 10. Now, number of people who do not like coffee, that is N of C dash. That is N of U minus N of C. What is N of U? I have already said it is 45. Minus N of C, it is 20. So, 45 minus 20, it is 25. So, number of people who do not like coffee is 25. Okay? Clear? Do you understand? I will explain why I took the universal set as N of T union C. Okay? Here, in this 45 people, there is no people who hates both tea and coffee, isn't it? Either they like tea or don't like tea, either they like coffee or don't like coffee, or either they like both tea and coffee. There is no person who don't like both tea and coffee. So, all these 45 people come within T and C. Okay? So, we can take that universal set is equal to T union C. Clear? There is no people who don't like both tea and coffee. So, we are considering N of T union C is equal to N of U. Clear? Now, we can go to the sixth question. In an exam, 50% of a student passed in maths, 70% students passed in science, and 10% students failed in both. 300 students passed in both. We have to find the number of students appeared for the exam. Okay, here the 300 students is the only number of students given. All other thing are given as percentage. So we want to find the percentage of the students passed in both. Okay, if we find that, we can able to find number of students appeared for the exam. Clear? Now 50% students who are passed in maths is indicated by M. Okay, the students who are passed in science is marked as S. Clear? Students passed in maths is M. Student passed in science is S. Now we know that 50% of the students passed in maths, isn't it? So N of M is 50%. 50% passed in maths, so N of M is 50%. 70% of students passed in science, therefore N of S is 70%. Now 10% failed in both maths and science. Okay, then we can find that 90% of them passed in both, isn't it? 90% passed in both, but we need to know the number of students appeared for the exam, isn't it? So we should proceed the calculation further. Okay, here 90% passed in both, what does it mean? What is this 90%? It is N of M intersection S. This 90% is N of M intersection S. But in the question, the 300 given, it is N of M union S, isn't it? So we have to find N of M union S. What is that? N of M union S is N of M plus N of S minus N of M intersection S. What is N of M? 50%. N of S 70% minus N of M intersection S, it is 90%. So 50 plus 70 is 120 minus 90. Clear? So we are going to find N of M union S and going to compare with the 300 students. Okay? So 50 plus 70 is 120 minus 90 is equal to 30%. Clear? So N of M union S, that is the number of students passed both maths and science, is 30%. So 30% of X is 300. Clear? What is X? X is total number of students. So 30% of total number of students is 300. So what is 30%? 30/100, isn't it? So 30/100 into X is 300. Clear? Now this 100 going to the right hand side becomes a numerator. So X is equal to 300 into 100 divided by 30. Okay? Dividing 30 and 300, it gives 10. So X is equal to 10 into 100, which is 1000. Clear? So the total number of students who are appeared for the exam is 1000. Clear? Any doubts? Here the only numeral given is 300 and it is N of M union S. So we are finding N of M union S and then finding X. Clear? Any doubts? If you have any doubts, please comment down. Okay? I will clear it for you. I have given the playlist in the description box. Please make use of it. Okay? If you watch the full playlist, you can understand even better. Meet you all in the next video. Till then, signing off, Padvina Ramesh. Bye-bye.
Subscribe, hit the bell, leave a like. If you have any doubts, comment down.